The Kenya National Cross Country Championship began the 2011 season with a two-day event based southwest of Nairobi. This rapidly growing discipline sees continued support from title sponsors Ganatra JCB, whilst Garmin, the navigational experts, have also come on board for the 2011 season. This rise in popularity has allowed the challenge to expand to four events over the course of the year. PJ Dave, Roses, in a senior, played host to scrutineering and the start of the opening leg, attracting a very respectable entry of 43 vehicles. Split amongst cars, bikes, buggies and quads, the season opener promised to be a real battle of the crews against the elements, especially with the opening leg comprising of nearly 70 kilometres of genuine cross-country terrain where navigation would play a vital role. Seeded car one was the winner of the final round of 2010, Simon Sharp. With Crispin Kennedy showing him the way, Simon had high hopes for the event.
We hope we go well, we hope our reliability is good. I think hopefully we sorted most of the teething problems from when we first built it. So yeah, we want to be competitive today.
Simon Crispin pushed hard from the very beginning and took the cross country title quite literally, as the pair chose a different route to everyone else very early on. This might have paid dividends if the gearbox in Simon's creation had not broken, causing their immediate retirement. Eddie Bulcher moved into an early lead in the car category, using the V8 powered Land Rover to full advantage. Nielsen and Roger Chaga would end the opening leg second in class. Whilst rallying stalwart Ben Muchemi was third quickest in his ex Marco Alain Subaru Legacy. Category, Jim Heather Hayes and Tim Jessup with the early paces. Ian Duncan in a single-seater buggy was second quickest through this first leg. Despite a persistent misfire, Altaf Ganatra was third and pleased to have gotten lost too many times. Taking a cautious start paid handsomely for Sean Miller as he kept on course and moved into the overnight lead. Newer ended day one just over a minute off the lead in second position. Eduardo De Bestiani was third in the bikes at the end of this first leg. Shazar Anwar was on a mission and quickly moved into an unassailable lead in the quads. Abid Ganatra was pushing his quad hard and went in day one second in class. Thank you. Despite an early misfire, Annick Dryder would finish the day third and just relieved to see the finish. In total, there were only two retirements from day one, although nearly everyone reported getting lost, including the two girls, Sophie Gavani and Nairin Ismail, but at least they were still in the event. Day two would be based around the Selenkai area, featuring two laps of the same route. The course was anticipated to have even more emphasis on off-road driving and navigational skills. Eddie Belcher, overnight leader in the cars, was one of the first away, but he would lose a lot of time on the first lap when end the rally fourth class. Third in the car category would go to Sammy Gibson. Salim Wali Hamid would end the debut event of his new car in second. Nish Lakhani was on a mission in his new car and would set the fastest time on both laps to move into the lead and ultimately win the car class. Charge ended rather suddenly in a mud hole. After getting stuck in one of the many ditches, Jim and Tim were happy to even finish, but then the buggy cars were little reward after their pace on day one. Ian Duncan finished second after turning his second lap into an economy run after almost running out of fuel. And through all the dramas came Altaf Ganatra to take a very well-deserved win. Vincent Bollinger would finish the event third in the quotes. Holding on to second position was Abid Ganatra. But proving to be untouchable up front was Shazar Anwar as he powered his quad to victory. In the biker category, he was all track. After leading overnight, Sean Miller would drop back to third by the end. Wangai Kameria would move into second position with two quick times Sunday. Showing the rest a clean set of heels and making up for the time lost on Saturday was Shivam Vinayak. His times were good enough to give him victory by over 13 minutes. The event also allowed the local Maasai to get up close to the action and prove very popular with the villagers. The next round of the 2011 Kenya National Cross Country Championship will take place over the weekend of 7th and 8th of May. We hope to see you there.